Today, we will talk about stability of trusses. Let's first define what is a truss. A truss is a special type of a frame. It is formed of triangular closed frame loops. The main difference between a truss and a frame is that every joint in the truss is an intermediate hinge. Most of the time, however, we do not draw the hinges in order to simplify the drawing. Whether we draw the hinge or not, since we call the structure a truss, then the presence of the hinges is implied. In the last lecture, we explained a general method to check the stability of frames. Since a truss is a special case of a frame, can we use that general method to check the stability of trusses? Of course we can. So why do we use another method for trusses? The answer to this question is simple. The truss method is easier to apply, but take care that it only applies for trusses. But what are the differences between the two methods? First, the number of unknowns and number of equilibrium equations are evaluated differently in both methods. Both methods may produce different numbers for both the unknowns and the equations. However, the difference between the number of unknowns and number of equilibrium equations will be identical in both cases. Therefore, the stability and determinacy check will produce the same output, irrespective of the method used. So how can we find the number of unknowns in a truss? The unknowns are classified into external unknowns, which are the support reactions, and internal unknowns. The number of internal unknowns is equal to the number of truss elements. To solve for the unknowns, equilibrium equations must be generated. The number of equilibrium equations in truss can be evaluated simply by counting the number of joints in the truss and multiplying this number by 2. To investigate the stability and determinacy of the truss, we use the same procedure as the general method used for frames. First, we compare the number of unknowns and the number of equilibrium equations. If the number of equilibrium equations is larger than the number of unknowns, then the structure is definitely unstable. If the number of equilibrium equations is equal to the number of unknowns, then the structure is probably stable and determinate. If the number of equilibrium equations is less than the number of unknowns, then the structure is probably stable but indeterminate. Now, let us look at the first example. The shown truss has a hinged support with 2 reactions and a roller support with 1 reaction. So the total number of reactions is 3. The number of truss elements is 19 as counted. So the total number of unknowns will be 3 plus 19 equal 22. The total number of joints in the truss is 11. So the number of equilibrium equations will be 11 multiplied by 2, which is equal to 22. Because the number of equilibrium equations is equal to the number of unknowns, then the truss is stable and determinate. Let us look at the next example. Similar to the previous example, the number of reactions is 3. However, the number of truss elements is 16 as shown. The total number of unknowns will be 19. The total number of joints in the truss is 9, giving 18 equilibrium equations. 2 equations for each joint. Because the number of equilibrium equations is less than the number of unknowns, then the truss is stable, but indeterminate. The degree of indeterminacy is equal to 1. Let us look at another example. For the truss shown, the number of reactions is 3, and the number of truss elements is 12. So the total number of unknowns would be 15. The number of joints in the truss is 8 as shown. giving 16 equilibrium equations. For this truss, the number of equilibrium equations is greater than the number of unknowns. So the frame is definitely unstable. The instability can be visualized by the failure mechanism generated due to a horizontal force at the top left corner. For the fourth example, the number of unknowns will be 15. 3 reactions and 12 truss elements. The number of equilibrium equations is 16. 8 joints multiplied by 2 equations per joint. Because the number of equilibrium equations is greater than the number of unknowns, then the truss is unstable. The instability can be visualized by the failure mechanism generated due to a vertical force at the middle as shown. To make the truss in example 4 stable, we can simply change the roller support at the right end to a hinged support. The number of reactions in this case will be increased by 1, and the number of unknowns will be increased to be 16 instead of 15. Therefore, the number of equilibrium equations will become equal to the number of unknowns, and the frame will become stable and determinate.